Hello and welcome to this video tutorial. Today I'm going to show you from start to finish how to list an item on eBay. Now we are on the desktop version of eBay. I will have a mobile guide on how to do this. I will link that down below as soon as I'm finished with that. So you've got an item and you want to sell it on eBay. Obviously you have to have an eBay account. I think you can probably do that. Just go to ebay.com, go to sign up, put in all your pertinent details, and get your eBay account. After that, you have no restrictions other than possibly the amount of money that you can sell something for to begin with. And again, you can just Google eBay restrictions to see those. So in order to sell and list an item, what you want to do is log into your account. Okay, so I've logged in here. And then what I want to do is up in the upper right-hand corner, you'll see something that says sell. So we can either go to sell here or we can go to my eBay with the drop-down menu and then go to selling. And then once here, you'll see a blue button that says list an item. So you can go this way or you can just click on sell in the upper corner here of the screen. It's now going to ask you to tell them what you are selling. So basically, this isn't the title of your listing. This is going to be you telling eBay what you're selling. So let's say you're selling some Pokemon cards, right? So let's go ahead and type in Pokemon pack. Okay, so we'll go ahead and search for Pokemon pack and we will start with that title there. Once we've typed in what we're selling, we are now taken to the item listing detail page. This is where we insert our title, our subtitle, all the pertinent information you would want folks to know about your listing. This is where all of the magic happens. Now, under title here, you probably don't just want to put Pokemon pack, right? You want to put something with more detail. So I'm going to do that now. As you can see, I've typed in a more detailed title. Now, eBay works very similar to other search engines like Google and YouTube and things like that. So you want to make sure that you are optimizing your listing to get the most views possible. So make your title and your images and all of the things here on your listing very catchy. So I have new. So if it's brand new, you can, you know, put new there. So you put new, sealed, and then what the name of the item is here. You don't want to do anything in all caps. I don't think eBay even allows you to do that, but you want it to look nice and neat and you want it to be very relevant to what you're selling. So this is where your title goes here. If you wanted to, you can check this box here and that would actually make your title bold in search results, but that will cost you an additional $2 to do so. So I'm going to uncheck that now. Now, if you want to have a subtitle, again, anything that costs extra money will have the amount that it cost in parentheses. So for a subtitle here, you could have something underneath your title. And then if you type something here, whatever you want your subtitle to be, you would just type it in there and that would show up below your actual title. So if you type anything in there, that will be considered a subtitle and you'd be charged accordingly. Next is going to be our category. This is very important as well. Make sure that whatever item you're listing is put in the correct category. So right here under category, you will see that this one eBay already has tried to figure out what it's in. They normally do a good job, but you do want to check it here just to make sure. So this is going to be in the category Toys and Hobbies, Collectible Card Games, CCG Sealed Packs. Now, if I was selling individual cards, this right here would be in individual or single cards. So again, if you want to change this, it'll show you a couple of maybe similar categories here you can choose from by just selecting or checking that box next to that category and then making sure that's what you want to do. If you've done this incorrectly, you could always click the change category option here and then go back and put the correct category. Now, if you want to add a secondary category, depending on the type of product that it is, you can click the add a second category option and then you can go and search categories or browse categories and select that second category just like so, finding whatever you want that category to be, just like I'm doing here, and then adding that as you would the first one. So again, depending on the item that you're selling, this could possibly cost more as well. All right, so next we're going to see something here that says UPC. If you know the UPC, maybe that's something you want to put here. This, with hitting any of these kind of eye or information buttons here, it lets you know what this actually is. So if you click on the eye here, it says buyers often search using product identifiers, and that's basically what a UPC is. But if you notice, that does not have a red asterisk next to it. Unless it has a red asterisk next to it like this one under condition or photos, you do not have to include that. So anything with an asterisk next to it, you do have to include something in that field. The next one now is going to be condition. So hit the drop-down menu, and then as you can see, new factory sealed, open boxed or used. So you have a couple of options here depending on the item. Go ahead and select whichever one applies to your product. And then we're going to move on to photos. Now, this may be the most important aspect of your listing on eBay. Under photos here, you can add up to 12 photos for free. And then if you want to add maybe a display or a gallery or something like that that looks even a little better, again, you can pay extra, obviously, to do so. So as you can see here, we can go to add photos. So if we go to add photos, we can click the add photos button here or here. And then once doing so, it will take us to our desktop where we can find that image that we want to add. So go ahead and search your computer to wherever you have sent the image to. Normally what I do is take a nice image with my iPhone and then go ahead and email that or airdrop that to my Mac computer, whatever is the easiest way to get the image on your device. And then once you've done so, just find that image, select it, or images, select all of them, and then click open or double click the images, and that will go ahead and start the loading process over on eBay. As you can see here, the photo in the upper left-hand corner here is going to be your main photo. So if we zoom in here, we can see that is our main photo. Any other additional images will be added over here, and those will be sub-photos or photos that will not show up as the main image. And what do I mean by main image? This is the one that shows up in search that when they haven't clicked on your listing yet, they will see this image. Now, if you are a good seller, which you want to be because you want to sell this quickly and for the most money, you probably want to add even more photos. The more photos you can add, letting them know the actual condition that it's in. Yes, you can say that it's new, you can say that it's factory sealed, but until they actually see that, they are not convinced. So understanding that and putting as many images as you possibly can, that is the best way of doing so. Now, once you've imported your images, you can do a couple of things. You can either delete all of them by clicking delete all here. You can even import images from the web. So if we click import from web, we can actually insert a URL here and that will insert that actual image. Or we can even edit images directly in the eBay photo editor. So as you can see here, we have a crop option by selecting this here, and we can drag the crop tool here and play around with it till we get the image exactly how we want it. We have a rotate option where we can rotate the image if that's something we want to do. We have a brighten option where we can brighten and adjust the brightness and contrast of the image, and a couple of more options where even one here that says auto adjust. I found that normally I don't mess with many of these, especially if I'm taking the image myself, but maybe you couldn't get a good photo and you need to add a couple of adjustments. If that's the case, you can do so here under the image editor. If you want to delete just this singular image that you're working on, you can just click the trash can icon here and that will remove that image. Now, again, you can pay extra for a large photo in search result called Gallery Plus. Again, you can pay for just about anything to make your listing stand out if that's something that you want to do. Now, we're moving on to item specifics. This is more of the nitty-gritty or details about your item. You can see here that we automatically updated item specifics. Configuration is a pack. The features is booster. Again, these are all data that eBay's bringing in from what you typed at the beginning of what you're selling. So you may have to go here and remove or tweak these if it's not, you know, kind of coinciding with what you're actually selling. Under recommended, it's going to show you a couple of things that eBay knows just by things that have already been listed, right? So you can add as many details as you can, and you can see 1.2 million searches for these details. Now, game. This is going to be, again, going to be listing specific. So these are things that are going to be specific to your listing. But again, unless it has a red asterisk, you do not have to do this. Now, again, the more of this you know, the more of this information you can provide, the better. So I'm going to go ahead and do a little bit of that now off camera, and then I'll show you what that looks like when I'm done. All right, I've added a little bit of the information now. As you can see, it's the Pokemon TCG is the game. It's a booster pack. The year manufactured is 2021. The number of cards in the pack is 15. Number of packs you're getting in this listing is 1. That's a very important, again, any detail like that's very important. And then you'll see some additional information. And again, the more of this that you can fill out, the more of this that you can provide to eBay, the better. But again, you don't have to provide any of this. So you can scroll on down until you see something here with another red asterisk that says item description. So as you can see here, under the item description, this is where you tell the folks what they're going to be getting in this listing. All right, as you can see, I've added some details and some information in the description here, and you can add as much or as little as you want. I found the more that you can tell them here, as with anything in a listing, the better you're going to be, because the more details that you have here, the less likely they are to bounce off your listing and to go somewhere else if you give them details like how it's going to be shipped, What condition is it in? Why are you selling it in a lot of cases, and kind of what the item actually is. So description is important, and you kind of decide how you want that to look. It works like a word processor. If you want to, you can select text here, you can bold text, you can highlight text, and if you wanted to, you can even number or bullet things by selecting them here and then going to bullets or numbering if you want them to be numbered. So again, all of that works like a word processor. Now we're moving on down to selling details. Now this one's very, very important. You'll have a couple of different selling formats here. We will have auction style or fixed price. An auction style listing is going to start an auction, just like think of an auction as if you were actually at the auction, right? Where you will start it at a starting price and you will say, we're starting at $5 and we're going to auction it off and let people bid until the highest buyer wins when that auction expires. That's what an auction is. Fixed price, fairly self-explanatory. A fixed price has one specific price of $20 and that listing will be good till canceled. So we're going to start with an auction style listing by going to the auction style here. And then as you can see, I want to start my listings when I submit them. You can actually schedule to start the listing on a specific date and time. This works good if you want your listing to end at maybe say when people are more likely to be off work or whatever that may be. But I'm going to start my listings when I actually submit this listing here that we're working on. Now, starting price. There's three different prices. There's a starting price, a buy it now price, and a reserve price. I'm going to explain all of them. The starting price, if we set it at $5, is where the listing will begin. So the starting bid will have to be $5 or higher. So that's how a starting price works. The buy it now price, if we set the buy it now price to be $75, okay, that will be a price that they can actually click the buy it now button and buy it right now and just eliminate and alleviate the whole auction process. They would buy that right now. And then the reserve price, which would be something, again, that is an additional fee for you as you're listing an item if you include a reserve price, is you basically saying that I don't want to sell this item for anything less than $25. So if the bid does not reach $25, do not let me sell this item because you don't want to sell something for a loss. Obviously, that's something that's very important, right? So again, that's what a reserve price is. So if it gets to $25, it meets the reserve price. And even if it's $25.25 and that's what the listing ends at, you will sell that item. Okay, that's what a reserve price is. Also, you have an option here to accept best offers. If they're like, okay, their buy it now price is 75. I don't have $75, but I'm going to offer them 70. And you're like, that's so close. I'll accept it. Okay. So again, you can accept offers if you want. This gets a little annoying where you do get a lot of notifications and people lowballing you. I normally don't accept best offers, but you can. And you can even automatically accept offers that are of at least a certain amount, like $70 or above, and automatically decline offers that are like lowballing offers that are like 50 and below. You can, again, choose to do that under best offer. Now, quantity. Let's say I have 5 packs, but they're all individual, things that I'm selling as individual items, then I would put 5 here, and then that would be very simple, right? That would have 5 of these things to sell, and once 5 of them run out and 5 have been sold, you're good to go. Now, with an auction style listing, you can't really do that, right? Like, you're selling one thing, you're auctioning off an actual entire item. But if you do right here and go to fixed price, you can change the quantity to be whatever you want to do. Private listing, you can allow buyers to remain anonymous to other eBay users, make a donation if you want to donate, and then under payment options. This one is extremely important. So payment options right here, we have PayPal. So you'll have to select PayPal here. So select PayPal, and then you would need to link your PayPal to eBay. So you would check PayPal, put your PayPal email address here, and then you are good to go. And a lot of this, if you haven't set this up, you can go to your selling options on eBay and you can add a couple of different options there as well. I like to get paid via PayPal. It's the easiest and most convenient way for me. And then you can have additional checkout instructions, like if it's a digital item and you need them to do something, you can put those instructions here if that's something that you need to do. And obviously, if you're a store or an individual and you have sales tax, again, depending on what state you're in, you may need to hit the drop-down menu here. I'm in Georgia, so I select Georgia, and then I put that percentage of sales tax that I need to sell. I believe it's 7%, somewhere around that area, and then you could put that there. Normally, most folks who are selling as individuals don't even do that. You can if you'd like. Under returns, this is letting the buyer know, do you accept domestic and international returns? I'm not selling this item internationally. If you're a U.S. seller, I recommend that you don't, unless you know how to handle customs. Those can be very difficult to deal with. And so if you accept returns, you can check which one that you accept. So domestic returns here. And then you let them know, hey, you have to return it within, say, 30 or 60 days. And then who will pay the return shipping, you or the buyer? Again, the more things that you offer like this, the more likely you are to sell items, obviously, because you're letting the buyer know, hey, if it's not what it's intended to be, I can return it if need be. Next, we're going to the shipping details, all right? So we have our domestic and international shipping. I'm not going to go over international shipping. That is a whole video in itself. Under domestic shipping here, we have flat, same cost to all buyers. This is the one that most folks go with. I will tell you this. A lot of times, buyers on eBay filter by free shipping, so you can price your item accordingly. If you know shipping is going to cost 10 bucks, the item normally sells for 50 bucks, maybe price it at 60. Free shipping, again, it's a visual thing. They see free shipping and they start, you know, free shipping is something that entices people to buy. So flat, same cost to all buyers. You can calculate it by using a service like USPS or UPS. Again, all of these drop-down menus are fairly self-explanatory. I'm just going to go flat, same cost to all buyers. And then what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to go to free shipping and the cost will be zero. But if you don't want to do free shipping, you just add the cost of whatever that flat fee would be right here and say that the shipping would be $10. You just type in 10 bucks here and that will add an additional 10 bucks and the buyer will see that when looking at your listing. So again, I'm going to select free shipping just for the easiness of this video. Now, if you did do calculate up here to calculate the shipping, you would need to know the dimensions, the height, the width, the length of your package or envelope that you'll be sending with this item. Is it an irregular package? You would need to check that here. But again, these are things that you would need to know and insert into the database here for eBay to know to calculate. And that way the service would know how much to charge for shipping. All right. In conclusion, at the very bottom, it says sell it faster. You can actually promote your listings and you can see where promoted listings, they actually promote your listing to a higher ranking on the search results. Or you can go to volume pricing where you basically have fixed price listings that are eligible for volume pricing when you add multiple listings and you start selling more. And these are things that maybe you can look into at a later date. Now, at the very bottom, you'll see something that says fees. This is going to be your total fee as of just the listing. Okay, this is not your fees for selling the item. This is your fees for just listing the item. Now, once you sell it, there will be additional fees and you need to click on the fees icon here and go to learn more to see, depending on the category you're selling in, what your fees will be. I'll tell you this, probably higher than you think they are. They average anywhere from 13 to 22%. I would look into that before you start selling. Now, we have a blue button here that says list the item, preview the item, or save as a draft. Those are all self-explanatory. I would always recommend go to preview. It'll open it up in a new browser tab, make it a little bigger, and now you can see what my item looks like here. Starting bid, have my reserve price, have the starting price, has my buy it now price. Looks very nice. Here's my description. If you are satisfied with that, you can close out of your preview and then go to the big blue button that says list item. Okay, so I'm going to save mine as a draft just for the purposes of this video. Now I'm going to cancel out of this and I am now going to take me to my eBay or my selling options here. So once back at the eBay homepage, we can go to my eBay and then we can go to selling, which is halfway down the little drop-down menu there. And then as you can see, all of your listings, if they're active, will show up here. So if you have active listings, it'll show the number of active listings, number of sold, a number of unsold items here as well. Right here is the drafts where we just listed that. So if we want to resume that, we can go and click the resume draft button there. And then down below here, we have our selling promotions and our monthly selling limits. Now for this specific eBay account, I can sell up to 15 items per month or a threshold of 1500 bucks. So if you're a new account on eBay, this is going to be very similar to what you may have access to. Now, once you start selling items, get a few positive feedback, then those limits will be raised and you can click on the little link here to see what the different limits are. And you can even request a limit increase if you think you have been limited a little more than you probably should have. So that is how you list an item over on eBay. Hopefully this was helpful. If it was, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And I will see you guys in the next video.